So chapter 5, capital markets continues. So 5.04, functions and importance of capital markets. So in the previous class, we saw about the functions and importance of capital markets, first 5 points. So out of 10 points, we saw 5 points in the previous class. The continuance of the previous class, that is functions and importance of capital market. Point number 6, reliable guide to the performance. The capital market serves as a reliable guidance to the corporate sectors, or industrial undertakings about the performance of financial securities, performance of the financial or business securities, and also promote the efficiency of the functioning of the industrial undertakings. So providing of information to the industrial undertakings or corporate enterprises about the sale of financial or business securities. And it helps to improving the efficiency or promotion of the efficiency of the industrial undertakings. So providing necessary informations to the business enterprises or corporate sector. Similarly, proper channelization of funds. Like the previous point, the guidance available to the public or the investors by way of supply of information about the market price as well as the income or yield of the securities. When the public invested their money in various companies, what should be the reasonable price? What should be the reasonable yield which are given by the various companies? So, the capital market providing assistance in the form of supplying of information to the public to invest in which company and ensure at the same time ensure the efficient or effective utilization of the funds by the invested by the public. So proper channelization of funds means the reliable guidance given by the capital market to the public or the investors by way of supplying of market information about the recent trends or prevailing market price as well as which company give more yield for the securities of the public and giving necessary guidance to the public to invest in which particular company. So in such a way, it ensures the efficient utilization of funds, near proper channelization of funds. So simultaneously, the capital market providing information to the corporate sector or business or industrial undertakings and increasing the efficiency or functioning of or the performance of the industrial undertakings. Similarly, also guidance given to the public or the investors by way of supplying of information about the market price, that is prevailing market price, as well as the yield of the securities, which is the beneficial company for the public or the investors, which give a higher price of the securities as well as the yield from the investment of securities. And in such a way, the proper channelization of funds, the amount which are invested by the public, ensure that the investments are properly channelized. That is, that should be placed in the productive purposes. That is, ensuring of effective utilization of funds which are invested by the public. Then, development of backward area. Another important of capital market is development of backward areas. So the capital market provide funds for the projects which are established in the backward areas or performed in the backward areas, and also useful for the development of backward area. So the capital market making necessary arrangements or providing funds for the projects which are established or inaugurated in the backward area. When the supply of funds in the backward areas projects, definitely it is useful for the development of such backward areas. At the same time, the capital market providing long-term funds also for the projects which are established in the backward area, which is helpful for the development of backward areas. So we simply say the capital market providing necessary funds or financial assistance those projects which are established in the backward areas. At the same time, long-term financial assistance or funds also provided by the capital market for the development of backward area. So in such a way, it is helpful for the development of backward area. It is one of the importance of capital market. Then foreign capital. So the capital market not only making necessary arrangements or generation of funds within the country, and also they are generating funds in foreign country also by way of foreign capital. That means the capital market generating funds not only our domestic country or within the country, and also generate funds in the foreign capital also. How it is possible? Indian companies can be able to generate funds from overseas market, that is abroad, by way of sale of their securities. Indian companies generate funds from the overseas market by way of sale of securities. It would be possible by way of the policy of the government, that is liberalization policy of the government. Then foreign direct investment. Foreign direct investment means the investors from foreign country can invest in our country with the help of the policy of the government, that is foreign direct investment in our country. So the capital market making necessary arrangements, not only the local funds, that is the domestic funds, and also foreign capital. The investors from foreign countries can invest their funds in our country with the help of the liberalization policy of the government, that is foreign direct investment in our country. At the same time, so not only the generation of funds by the Indian company from outsiders, that is other country, and also import of foreign technology also. So in addition with that, the generation of funds by foreign direct investment and also import of foreign technological development into our country. So import of foreign technological development in our country with the inertia with the foreign capital, that is foreign direct investment. So this is foreign capital. So the foreign investors or the investors from other countries can invest their funds in our country through the liberalized policy of the government, the scheme of foreign direct investment, and also the import of foreign technology. The last one is easy liquidity. Easy liquidity means the securities or the financial instruments or financial claims can be converted into cash as quick as possible without much difficulty. That is easy liquidity. So with the help of secondary market, the investors can sold off their securities and that should be converted into cash easily. So one of the important of the capital market is conversion of the financial securities into cash of the investors. At the same time, the capital markets allow the commercial banks. Commercial bank allow the customers or the depositors withdraw their money from their account when they needed funds. That means the commercial banks allow the customers or the account holder to withdraw the money from the deposits or from their account whenever they are needed funds. So the liquidity can be possible in both the cases. That is conversion of the securities into cash by way of sold off. At the same time, the commercial banks allow the customers or the account holder to withdraw their money or the deposit from their accounts whenever they are needed funds. So these are the 10 important functions of the capital market. So we saw 5 points in the previous class, the remaining points are the reliable guidance to the performance of the corporate enterprises or industrial undertakings and promote the efficiency. And proper channelization of funds by way of guidance given to the public or the investors and in the supplying of information about the market price of the securities and yield from their respective securities from the respective invested companies. So it ensures the proper utilization of funds for the productive purposes. Then development of backward areas, providing necessary funds, particularly the project which are inaugurated or established in the backward areas, and it is highly useful for the development of such areas. Not only that, and also providing long-term funds to the projects which are established in the backward area. Then foreign capital. So the foreign investors also attracted by the liberalization policy of the government through foreign direct investment. So the Indian company can be able to generate funds from overseas market in addition with the import of foreign technologies. Then easy liquidity. So conversion of cash, the securities can be converted into cash without much difficulties, without any obstacle or any hindrance. At the same time, the commercial banks allow the withdrawal money by the account holder from their account whenever they are needed funds. So with the end of the functions and importance of capital market, which is 5.04.